Good evening. Australia's biggest names in entertainment are tonight on COVID alert, with the star-studded AACTA Awards feared to be Sydney's next super-spreader event. An infected person who worked at the Opera House on the night is among a rising number of cases in New South Wales, as Queensland prepares to open up to our state, hopefully for good.
The Opera House Wednesday night. The stars of television and film walk the red carpet for the AACTA Awards. Eric Banner, Taika Waititi, Rachel Griffiths and Rebel Wilson.
Did you manage to get an exemption to get out of quarantine?
Not nominated, but working the room, COVID-19. Tonight, the awards are just the latest exposure site as the silly season turns to spreader season.
If any of you over the next few days get COVID, we need you to shut up.
And we reiterate just how important it is for people to not attend social functions if they have any symptoms, even if mild.
560 new cases across New South Wales, our largest jump in 2 months, including 7 from the Albion Hotel in Parramatta. Anyone at the pub last Sunday afternoon is being told to isolate, with the case likely the Omicron variant.
To date, there have been no cases with Omicron variant admitted to hospital for COVID-related care in New South Wales.
In the state's north, the long wait to get into Queensland is almost over.
I'd love to go 1 a.m. on the 13th, but no, I don't want to sit in a traffic jam for 4 or 5 hours.
Norm Brown will cross the border in time for Christmas with his brother.
I've spoken to him on the phone, and over a year. And I miss him.
I'm camped here for 3 nights to wait for the Anna to let me through the border.
Mick Devlin left his Queensland home in August and has been locked out of the state since. Tonight, hundreds are treading water at Byron. 30 cars still in line at this testing site, 15 minutes before it was due to close. A swab is needed in the 3 days before crossing into Queensland, but these results aren't likely to be back in time for Monday's opening, with many waiting over 48 hours.
From Monday, we are going to have thousands and thousands of people flocking from hotspots into Queensland. Yes, they're fully vaccinated, but they can bring the virus.
A virus already in the Sunshine State.
We believe that they are a casual contact at a Bunnings store. So it just reminds all of us that you can get this virus anywhere.
The next chapter in our 2-year border battle about to play out.
And Charles Croucher joins me now. Charles, there's a last-minute hurdle for Sydneysiders who are heading to Queensland on Monday.
It's that border pass, Mark, and that's to be filled out by everyone before they enter the Sunshine State. It's only going to become available tomorrow night at midnight Queensland time. That's an hour before the border opens. Queensland health officials say they have faith that their IT systems will be able to handle the thousands of people that will be attempting to access those passes on Monday morning. But any crash or any clogging of the website will only add to confusion and delays. Once you get that pass, travellers will also have to show their vaccination certificate and a negative test result on their way across the border, Mark.
We'll see how it goes. Charles, thank you.